Gonna cover Azure resource groups in this video. So what are Azure resource groups? They're a way to basically group together resources logically, okay? And they fall underneath their subscription. To really explain this, I put together this diagram. Okay, so what we're looking at is in the middle right here, Azure, the resource groups right here. And you can see there's actually three clouds here, the AWS cloud, Azure, and Google cloud right here. And subscriptions kind of belong the same level as accounts in AWS if you're coming from that world. And they belong at the same level as kind of the Google project level, okay? But in the Azure world, underneath subscriptions, you don't create your resources directly underneath the subscription. You create it under actually another layer, the resource groups layer, okay? So when I was starting off with Azure, I was like, oh, well, that's a little bit annoying. It's easier in AWS and Google. I just create my resources underneath the projects account and I'm kind of done. I don't have another layer of abstraction. So the con is you have to kind of manage this extra kind of layer here, but there's some pros with resource groups too, okay? So we'll kind of talk about some of those pros actually and how we should maybe possibly use resource groups, okay? So to do that, we're actually going to go to the Azure portal here and actually we're clicking resource groups here. So you see here my resource groups, and I'm just gonna create a new one just so you can see how easy it is to create a resource group. I just create one under the subscription right here and just call it test. You just click review and click create and that's it. That's all you need to create a resource group, okay? So it's just a logical container, okay? And then under there, if you wanted to, I can go click on, let's say virtual machines here. And I already have a virtual machine under this demo East US resource group. I create another one. Virtual machine here, and then I can specify right here the test resource group that I just created and name it. Okay, I'm not gonna go through the whole process of creating a VM here. I did that in another video. But the point is you create your resource and then they belong to a resource group. Okay, so what's the advantage of resource groups? Well, resource group, it makes it very clear where resources live. If you go and click on the menu here and then go look for resource groups again, let's click okay here. I don't need the safe information there. And click on demo East US. Here's the virtual machine that we're just looking at, okay? But you can see when I spun up that virtual machine, all I did was spin up a virtual machine, okay? And I also spun up a network. But then as part of that virtual machine, it also created a public IP address, a network security group, a network interface, a disk, and I also created SSH keys. You can see kind of just everything very clearly what belongs to that resource group, okay? So now this kind of begs the question, like how should you use resource groups and how you should organize it, okay? So here are my thoughts on that. Okay, resource groups, people use it different ways depending on their needs, okay? I know that's a very general kind of answer there, but resource groups, it really depends, okay? Okay, some people use it to group all the resources under like a development environment and production environment, okay? And that's kind of one way to use it, and it makes sense for some resources, and I'll explain it a bit. But also makes sense actually to group your resources under environment dash application. So basically all the resources, so let's say that belong to, let's say a front-end API application and the development for development, all the resources belong there. So it makes it very clear and easy to see all the resources belonging to front-end API, okay? Or back-end API, okay? And then you can see that there's just nice separation there, but some resources, okay? Are not really app-centric, right? Like for instance, an AKS cluster. If you want to create like an AKS cluster, a Kubernetes cluster, that doesn't really belong in an app unless you want to cluster per app and then you don't get container density. So it's not, you're not really leveraging resources that efficiently. You might want like a common development cluster and then you could deploy all your applications there. So that actually makes sense to group at the environment level, you see? So I feel like there are two levels that you should group things at. You should group things at the environment level and then a secondary level, the application level. So everything kind of falls underneath there, okay? So logically you kind of know where everything kind of fits, okay? Now, again, you might be wondering, well, what's the benefit of like this resource group and grouping things as another layer of abstraction? Well, I show you that you can clearly see the resource groups and where they live under here or the resources within the resource group and where they live, right? But a really kind of a big advantage is if you need to delete all the resources underneath a certain scope, it's very easy. You just delete the resource group and everything underneath it gets deleted, okay? Now, of course, for environmental basis, that sounds extremely dangerous, right? Application basis, it sounds pretty dangerous too, but a really good use case is actually, let's say you have a developer or engineer who wants to deploy new resources, he just wants to test things out. Well, give him a resource group, okay? And then he could create all his resources in there and then to delete all the resources, all his VMs, all his networks, all the stuff, basically the trash that he's, you know, when you start learning something, you're gonna create a bunch of trash. You can all clean up very quickly and easily, okay? It's actually really great for demos, okay? So here, this demo, I'm actually delete all the resources now associated with this by deleting the resource group. I'm gonna show you how to do that. Click delete here, then you just type in the resource group here, demo East US, and then you just click delete, okay? And then it's gonna delete the resource group and then all the resources underneath it, okay? I'm also gonna just go back and just delete the test resource group also. Might as well just do that one too, okay? Test, and now just delete this one, okay? And since it's deleting all the resources in here, it is gonna take some amount of time, okay? So I'll come back right when this is all finished. Okay, so the resource group finished deleting. I just got a notification up here. If you click on here, you can see it. Delete resource group demo East a few seconds ago. So now you kind of refresh this. It's gonna say it's kind of no longer there. All the resources are kind of gone. Okay, and you just click on this. Okay, basically the demo East US resource group and the test resource group is now gone. So like just like that, we were able to clean up all the resources very cleanly, okay, with essentially one click. It's a very powerful thing, obviously, but also kind of good way to kind of give basically sandboxes for you guys to test on and everything. So I think that's actually a pretty interesting concept. Again, it's another layer of abstraction, but in some instances, it's actually pretty nice, okay? Okay, thanks.